Hello, I'm Helen Matthew and I'm a grassland and forage specialist at Germinal. This is Tony Ball, farming here in partnership with his brother. Can you tell us a little bit about your farming system, Tony, please?
Yes, we're farming 750 acres on four separate sites. We've got a centralised dairy unit. We're milking 500 cows through a robotic milking system and all year round calving.
Excellent. What sort of milk yields are you sort of pushing on with, and how much are you relying on forage to produce milk, to produce your milk from forage figures? That's what I'm after.
We're averaging around about 10,000 litres a cow at the moment. Yeah. I'm relying more and more on forage, so obviously as feed prices are increasing, we're looking for more and more milk from forage.
Excellent. So we're standing here in a lovely crop of red clover. How long have you been growing red clover?
So we sowed our first field of red clover in 2018. It was more of a look-see initially. We'd grown quite a lot of white clover in the swards. Thought we'd try a little bit of red, see what difference it gave us. We found it performed very well. We're encouraged by that. And when next year it came and we had more fields to put down to grass, we put some more mixes in. It's grown from there and we're now growing 125 acres of it.
Across the whole platform?
Across the whole platform.
So you've got a rotation going, Tony, with the red clover, and then it'll go into... What's your following crop after red clover, for example?
So some fields will have to go into wheat because they're not suitable, but where possible we'll go into a maize crop, another maize crop, a wheat crop.
Yeah.
Probably same again, maize, wheat, and potentially back into red clover again.
And back into your red clover rotation. Mm. That's good, thank you. And are you finding your red clover silage lays, they yield as well as your grass lays? You get good yields from them?
Yeah, we've been very pleased with the yields. Yeah. And what we have found with the red clover in the dry period when grass swards will stop growing, the red clover just keeps on going.
Yeah, excellent. Have you adjusted your fertiliser policy to cope with the nitrogen fixing really from the red clover? You're putting less nitrogen down?
We are nowadays, certainly, yes. Yeah. I was a little bit nervous to start off with, and the first year we probably didn't pull it back as much as we could have done. But certainly last year we were minimal nitrogen. We put some sulphur with nitrogen on early on, just to give the grass a bit of a boost. And then a little bit of slurry after first cut silage.
Yeah.
But other than that, no artificial nitrogen.
Excellent. And this year, obviously very topical with the price of nitrogen. How much have you dared put on this year? Or have you made it do it all itself?
No, we have again put some sulfur with some nitrogen early
just
on. So 40 kilograms to the hectare of nitrogen, 45 of sulfur at the end of February, early March.
Very low.
And then it leads...
Just look at this, yeah.
Leads to a nice crop like this, and hopefully it'll carry on this season with no more nitrogen.
Excellent. So minimal applications of nitrogen, Tony. What about phosphate and potash? Do you rely just on slurry, or do you find you've got to top up with P and K?
No, we're quite a simple system. We put either double top, so we put nitrogen or sulphur, or we put straight ammonium nitrate on and rely on muck and slurry to
keep
the P's and K's right.
So when you're selecting a red clover silage lay, what are you looking for? Is it persistency? Is it you know, the multiple cutting? So this is a multi-cut mixture, I think, isn't it, with red clover added? How do you select that sort of mixture?
Well, we are looking to reduce intervals between silage cuts to get a better... better quality of silage, and automatically the multi-cut selection that you offer appealed and it's performed well for us.
Excellent. This is coming for its first cut now?
First cut now, yes.
Yeah, we've got some early flower bud, but basically it coincides with everything else that's going on the farm at the moment.
Yes, and that's the thing we're looking for. We don't want to keep sheeting and unsheeting the clamp. We want the silage in one hit, so it's all got to fit in together.
Going in one go. And how many times do you think you'll be cutting this crop?
This crop will be cut either three or four times. It depends a little bit on the grazing situation. Sometimes we can get dry weather late summer, it'll stop growing.
Yeah.
And that may mean that we need to put some young stock on here just to graze it off.
That's good, yeah. So multiple cuts, you're cutting it three or even four times. You know, we hear that red clover was supposed to try and let it flower, so it's quite early at the moment. Will you be looking, you know, what we'd be looking to achieve in those cuts? You're hoping it to get it into flower at least once a year?
We are conscious it does need to flower at one point during the season.
Yeah.
We usually find that nature will sort itself out, so we'll get a dry spell and grass won't grow and the clover will carry on growing and go to flower, so it kind of sorts itself out.
So you do get that opportunity for it to build up its root reserves for winter at least once a year?
Absolutely, yes.
Excellent.